there, mate.
Yeah, well, not to the pole yet.
6 months of training. Almost ready.
Almost there. Be good.
Pretty good. Excited?
I'm really looking forward to it. I'm really looking forward to it. Carrying all these bags, literally gonna have to drag everything that you see is gonna have to be dragged behind us. So we've tried to pack light.
It doesn't look like you pack light to me.
Then we're off. It's the cold. Got me aquamarine though, I'll be fine. Aquamarine, good for travels. Gemstone for adventurers. And my RDA watch. The watch of explorers, RDA. It's an aquamarine RDA, what can go wrong?
It'll be good.
Have you done enough training?
Probably not, but I've done as much as I'm going to be able to right now. So yeah, we'll see if we've done enough later on when we get to the North Pole and how hard it is.
Look at this, it's not dried food yet.
No, not yet. Enjoying this one, the last English breakfast for a long, long time.
Jake's hand luggage. Jake's, not mine. Real men wear pink.
Only a few hours away, Phil, from finding out if we've done enough training.
Absolutely. We never do enough training, so...
Get some ice under our feet, making it feel a bit more real now.
Still don't think you should have that pink bag though, Jake. This is brilliant. I couldn't believe it when he bought that. Couldn't believe it. Should have got a load of bags and my daughter said no, it's the right one for Jake.
Good to see you, our leader.
Thank you very much, I'm glad you all arrived. After a little scare by email.
Yeah.
The number two mine up there.
Yeah.
So you can walk up there and go in it.
What, the coal mine?
Yeah, up there, that one up there.
Cool.
The hill. We can take a walk up if you want.
Yeah.
This is the normal, the little prep score then. Yeah. Leopard seals, aren't they?
Anyway. So Jake? On the menu tonight, you can choose seal or fish. Any preference?
No, both sound as grim as each other.
I mean, looks in quite good nick.
Gonna eat a whole one though.
You were trying to do it with a dog tail.
From the end of February onwards, Longyearbyen just doesn't go dark. It won't be now for another 5 or 6 months till they'll see a starry sky.
The
This is trying to pick up the sleeping bags and things, is it? Or
yeah, but I don't think they're actually here today.
Anybody home?
Right, we need to find the lights. Let's get the light from Bango. Find the lights, Brent.
I'm looking.
The big red button.
Okay.
All skis in the bag are broken or on repair. Oh, no, good one.
It's not of the broken ones, though.
No, it's not of those ones. We've got to manual beast, don't we? Right, what we need to do is get four pairs of good skis off this pile here, guys.
That's good.
He was out.
Yeah, so you think there'll be a delay, Alan?
I don't know. We don't know. There might be one day delay or...
Maybe one day delay, I think, yeah.
Yeah.
At the moment, it looks like not a large, not long delay.
Yeah.
Hopefully it'll stay that like this.
And the ice report?
They say...
We heard it's good. Yeah, we heard.
It's good. The floor is not too large, maybe, but it looks... Okay.
Good ice.
Why do you ask in general, right?
Ice. Yeah, just my little bit I'm bothered about. And our boxes are on the flight from Russia.
Yeah, so same with our boxes.
And is that coming here, Mikhail? Or is it going to Barnier?
No, it comes here.
Yeah.
At least that was said.
Yeah.
So you never know for sure.
I hope so. So when you find out that's coming here, can you...
Tomorrow, yeah.
Let me know and we'll...
Yeah, we'll give you a call.
Yeah, because I need the box... I need the boxes before they go to Barnier.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Same as ours.
The plane will be totally unloaded first. Yeah. So all the cargo that's not supposed to go to Barnier will stay here.
Yeah, good. It should have my name on it anyway.
Yeah, mm-hmm. They don't want to take any... They don't have the space for any... And the first taking of flight is fully loaded.
That's good. So if you can call me when that plane comes and we'll just come and collect...
So what sort of day do you think we might be going?
Well, we've planned to fly on the 2nd, but what you're saying is maybe the 3rd now.
Maybe, we'll see. Yeah. But right now they're working, so 300 metres is good.
Yeah. This is Leo, the smiling assassin. Everything is always good.
Yeah.
Even if it's bad, it's good.
Yeah.
That will be fine.
Yeah.
Not many groups this year.
Oh, no.
No.
Jake? Not too bad, not too bad. Filling up the food bags. Each of these, that's one day of food. Or it will be when we finish.
You got enough calories there, Phil?
Who knows? I expect to lose some weight.
Yeah.
Chocolate bars, yeah.
You've obviously got a palate like mine.
But I have got pork scratchings, which I do like, and I have got nuts, and I'm wild about nuts. And in a few of these, I've got Snickers, and I really like Snickers, so that's fine, but yeah.
Really starting to love you, Alan, then.
You like this?
Yeah, oh, no, if I can swap my bleach for two of those.
Yeah. You're happy now?
I'm happy. That means...
You know, it doesn't matter which one you put in each one, Jay.
Yeah.
I would like, I make sure you have two of the same each day, though. Otherwise, you're Stilton and...
Oh, hang on a minute, then.
Oh, Jay, look what you've done, man.
There we go, that's
all right. Start all over again. Dear me. You know your theory of always leaving from the back out? You might have to drag us along, I think.
Once we get out there, you'll all be fine.
So let's say that's enough food. So 4,200, 4,300 calories a day.
By the time we get the hot Ribena in, about 4,500 calories a day. So.
Well. Final practice of the tent indoors.
Trying to sew through Gore-Tex is not easy. I've got a needle that supposedly is deliberately bent, like a fish eye. I've got a tail off something, but apparently it's going to save my life and keep me warm, so I better hope my sewing's as good as my mother's.
Do you see the temperature at which this bag starts overheating?
No, when?
If you sleep in this bag,
yeah.
Above minus 24,
yeah.
Then you start overheating.
Do you?
Yeah, that's how cold you have to be.
Is that what it says?
Yeah.
You've read the instructions already?
Yeah.
So we just had word from the Russians that looks like we might be going in the morning. If not the morning, maybe tomorrow afternoon. So this is the frightening bit. This is putting everything into the sledge and hoping that you've got everything. Last minute I realised I hadn't got any toilet paper, so I went and bought, oh, let me see that, some toilet rolls. On the bed there, got some toilet rolls, jackets, we got the two water bottles, that's for weeing in the night inside your sleeping bag, that's going to be interesting, and that's your drinking one, different colours so you don't get them wrong. What else have I got? Knife and fork, cooker, lovely photographs of my wife and my children, just in case I get really lonely, not if, I will. Big sleeping bag, lots of coats, boots, walking boots, and it's all got to go in the sledge.
This way, you're putting a screwdriver and screws underneath of your skis. That's sacrilege, man. I know, you'd think so. You would think that drilling screwdrivers into your skis just before you're about to go on the longest skiing journey you've ever done would be madness. But it's because these furs are what's almost going to absolutely make the journey, and the last thing that we can possibly have happen is for those furs to come off. So you put the screws in, get them nice and flush, like this one here. Hopefully this one here will go in a bit more.
It's a little bit frustrating. We were supposed to have gone yesterday morning. Then last night we were told that we'd definitely go at 10 o'clock today. But we're still stuck in Svalbard. They've only landed on the ice successfully once so far. Now they're telling us they've got technical issues. And they're now saying there's every chance we might go in 4 or 5 hours. So that would be 6 p.m. Doesn't matter about darkness because there is no darkness on the North Pole. So we'll land maybe 8, 9, 10 o'clock tonight. And then we're going to ask the Russians to fly us backwards in their helicopter because at the moment the drift is such that the Barnia, the camp they set up, on the ice for 3 weeks, he's drifting towards the pole too quick. And if it does that, then we're not walking the last degree. And I wonder what the last degree, because that was the whole idea of the challenge. So all being well, touch a bit of wood. We think we've negotiated to go backwards as soon as we land with a helicopter, drop us off, and then we'll probably sleep straight away so we can get into the right sleep pattern and then probably start walking tomorrow morning, all being well.
Steve, mate.
Yeah, just spoke to Alan.
Yeah?
We're getting the 6:20 flight.
Seriously?
Today, tonight, yeah, tonight. We've got the green light.
Are you winding me up or we are going?
No, genuinely. I mean, I know the Russians have wound us up a couple of times, but we are going tonight in a couple of hours' time.
So what we got to do?
We're looking at a 2.5 hour flight onto the Barnio, and the jet plane lands on an ice runway, sea ice runway, so... we should hope to stop. It stops in about 700 feet. And then...
tell us about you were saying to start the runway off, they have to parachute in
digger. So Russian Marines free fall in at minus 40. And then they parachute bulldozers in. And then they parachute in some tentage. And they start doing the runway after free falling in onto the ice.
Yeah. This is it. We're about to get on the plane.
You want to film?
So let's go.
Boss?
Yeah, all good.
Oh,
сформировано здесь. Давайте сядьте, они вас пересчитают уже. Заодно.
Say again, mate.
We're only about 100 feet up in the air with no visibility, so hopefully we'll be landing in Barnet strengthening in about 2 minutes. See how big all these are.
What happens if we come across one of those?
Fine. We'll find a gap, we'll find a place to cross. We might have to go east and west a little bit, but another thing I've seen coming in is majorly worrying. It's a shame we've got really bad visibility, so fingers crossed helicopter will actually pick us up and take us tonight to our start point.
Landing I've ever had, and we've just landed on ice. Unbelievable. Try to begin to describe how it feels. Stood on a metre of ice, maximum of 2 metres, 11 p.m. and the sun is so bright, it's just clear as day. Absolutely clear as day. Indescribable feeling. Indescribable.
The plan is to go loose tonight, helicopter, over the pole, 89 degrees, full degree. And then we'll be there about midnight. So tent up, sleep, and have a full day tomorrow. But it's a really strong drift of current underneath the ice. So we're not going to fight the current, we're going to go with it.
They're just unloading the plane, and you can see all these parcels here are letters to Father Christmas.
Direction southwest. Southwest. So I suggest that we are now here. So we fly all together, and we fly to the North Pole. Maybe it's not very good for you, but we unload equipment and Eric expedition, yes, there. And after that we fly 89, maybe 180 or something, maybe 160 east. So for you to have drift helping you,
yeah,
in progress, because I don't know if you saw the surface, and the ice is pretty much broken. So
there's
it's
a lot of low clouds,
lots of open leads. Some leads are frozen, but its condition is not very good. But it is good enough. It is good enough. And we continue flying to 89 degrees,
and about 160 longitude east. So in this case, they move more than 500 meters from the territory of the base.
Два дня назад были встречены три белых медведя.
Здесь. 2 days ago, there were three polar bears here. One mother bear and two cubs, but 2-year-old cubs. So they are pretty big ones.
На территории базы есть врач, квалифицированный хирург.
We have a doctor, medical doctor, surgeon on the base.
Сейчас мы его представим.
Steady, my love. Yours are the eyes that have seen God. was all the eyes that have seen God. Fire to the left, water to the right, on your sacred, sacred journey. Steady, steady your eyes, my love. Keep your gaze steady, my love. Yours are the eyes that have seen God. Keep your gaze steady, my love. Yours are the eyes that have seen
God. 160-13-09 East. Yeah, team very good. Good day. Good visibility, good conditions, all is well. Yes, definitely. Good weather for flying. Yeah, good visibility. Thank you, Victor. Bye-bye.
It was really, really cold by now. Temperature minus 35 to minus 40. And the cracks, the crevices, what we call the leads, were getting more frequent. Literally every 10, 15 meters, we were coming across open water. We arrive at a really big lead. This one's a huge problem. So Alan goes off first to test the waters to see if he can get across, leaves his sledge behind, and tells us that if he does fall in, that we've got to come and fish him out. Of course, that's the least we could do.
You've read my book, Let Me Go Gem Hunting. You've read the principle of shaving the bolt, which is about doing absolutely to the nth degree all the little detail that makes that 1 or 2% difference between the winners and those that come second and come third, or those that just participate. It's always just that 1 or 2% that makes the difference. So read my principle of shave the bolt. But Alan took that to a whole different degree when he went from Canada to the North Pole. When he got his MBE from the Queen, being the first British person ever to walk that long, long distance of 70 days, you won't believe the degrees he went to. Alan, tell us a story about when you were, tell us a little one about the shoelaces. I love that story.
Great. For me, it's not just about starting the journey with an improvement, it's a continuous improvement. So every 12 hours, We try to improve. We didn't wait to the end of the week, the end of the month, the end of the degree north to try and reevaluate to improve every 12 hours. Some nights there were no ideas, but once we got in the tent and we got a little bit warm, we tried to be very creative and drill holes in things to lighten the load. And I think that the smallest bit of weight we got rid of was we pulled the 1 centimetre of plastic coating off the end of our shoelaces or our bootlaces. We knew we didn't need them. We could melt the end of the lace. We knew it wouldn't fray, so we didn't need the one centimetre plastic that wrapped around the boot lace.
Great story, that.
6 p.m. Monday afternoon. We've got the sat phone on standby, waiting for a call from Barney to find out what time they're bringing the helicopter in. Real shame for Phil. He's 69 years old, but he's absolutely fit as a fiddle, runs and does everything. Wasn't very good at managing his own gloves, and Alan tried everything to help him out, but wet gloves are a recipe for disaster. And the key thing is, when you've got a leader, you've got to listen. If you've got somebody that's in charge, that's done it before, listen, take advice, listen to what they tell you. They say dry feet, dry hands is all important. Then it is. The same in any business, just like business. You've got to listen. You don't have to agree with everything, but listen, take it all in. I think that's what's been missing. So four's going to be three, and we'll make sure that three gets the pole in a couple of days.
You alright, leader?
Just chilling out. It's 15 minutes before phone call, so breakfast done, evacuation all sorted out, flasks made. Finally dried my iPhone out after finding it in the snow 2 days ago. I'm desperately trying to remember these words.
To 6 p's?
Yeah.
Okay. Warming up my boot, trying to mould it to my foot.
Worried that it might be melting, so...
Is it? Okay, yeah. Okay. I'll turn the camera off then and see what... Try to mould it because the boot's a bit too small. It's scrunched up all my toes. And after what's happened to Phil, Alan's told me he doesn't want any more. Oh, that's been silly. So I've got to do my boots properly today. So I'm in off.
Day four at the North Pole. We're some 30 miles still to go, which is exactly halfway. Unfortunately, this morning, 8 o'clock, Phil woke up and he got frostbite really bad on his thumb. First finger, second finger, just a little bit on the fourth finger, and knowing you just can't carry on at that stage. So we called in for the helicopter at 10 o'clock. They told us they'd be here at 1 o'clock. Then they had some technical issues. Then they told us they'd be here at 5 o'clock. Then they found out they hadn't got fuel for the helicopter. And now they tell us the helicopter should be here within the next half hour to hour, so in between 9:30 and 10:30. And believe it or not, this is 10:30 at night at the North Pole. It just does not get dark this time of year. Or you're in your sleeping bag. That's the only two warm places up here. So you know exactly where I'm going right now while we wait for the helicopter. And I'll see you for a bit to camera, probably when the helicopter arrives.
Just seem to just flown straight by, didn't they? Definitely going the right coordinates, I think.
The helicopter's now on its way. A little bit tentative times because started off over there, went right past us, and started heading off into the distance. That was about 5 minutes ago. Alan just made an emergency call through to Camp Barnier, to Victor, to give him our updated coordinates, because obviously, because we're on sea ice, the drift could move us so quickly that the helicopter just simply could not find us to evac fill out. Looks like it's heading our way now. It's certainly come closer, but again, we've still got to make hope that the helicopter can find us as a team.
Yeah. It's still not quite got that coordinate, has he? Maybe they're working off a different map that we're working off. Wave your arms, Jake. Wave your arms.
They said they had no fuel.
Really?
You could have fueled me.
Come on, you must be able to see the tent from there.
When landing on snow, the helicopter pilots often have a problem judging the distance to the ground. But not when Alan Chambers is around, because he runs out in front of the helicopter, kneels down, and guides in the helicopter. He literally will be underneath his helicopter in about 5 seconds' time.
Day 6, depending on whether you count Thursday.
What, that midnight day?
Yeah. Day 6. All is good.
All good.
Three little pigs in a tent.
Quite a big river, so we can probably get across this bit. In fact, we've got a cross bigger than this, but Alan's run off there because the problem is the other side is a huge river, and we were doing amazing today. We covered a lot of ground, but now we're a little bit stuck.
Complete when you're with me, 'cause we
maybe our last morning, possibly penultimate morning. But we had a really, really long day yesterday. You know, we had eight to 10 hours in the harness, pushed out some serious miles, and was always debating whether we get so close to the pole, do we try and do it in one go and really, really stretch ourselves, or we break it down into 2 days and have two comfortable days. So a lot of decisions to make. So the plan is to get up this morning, try and crank out 8 to 9 miles, see where we're at. Mm. You know, look at the situation, look at the ice, the weather, how we're feeling. We're exhausted last night. And then see how close we are away from the pole, which then raises quite a few questions. Do we sleep and then lose the pole by drifting over it? Do we get so close that we could push ourselves and really, really go for it on a really long, hard day? Or do we stop early and give ourselves quite an easy day the following day? So it's either going to be a really, really long, tough day, digging really deep today to make it. And we're talking 30 kilometres today, dragging sledges at minus 30 degrees. Or do we break it down into two? So we've set ourselves a daily goal. In the back of our mind, we've got a really, really big goal that we're going to push ourselves forward, depending on how we feel after 8 hours.
Yeah, how the ice is looking, weather, stuff like that.
Yeah.
Sounds like a plan.
So Alan's given us a sort of a target for the day, which is 8 or 9 miles, leaving it a reasonably straightforward push on the last day, or a bit of a stretch target that, all going well, we might even be able to get there this evening. And we'll see what happens. We'll see what the day brings.
It's already early afternoon, so we've still got about 9 miles to go, which makes Alan's stretch target not really doable now, I wouldn't have thought. But it was certainly worth having a go. The obstacles today have been just immense, and I think the fatigue of yesterday has just slowed me down a little bit. I don't know about the rest of the team, but so unlikely we'll get the stretch target, but at least I think we'll hit the goal, which is still good.
yapsın jogi.
Got out the window now. It's late afternoon, still about 5 miles to go, but we're all absolutely knackered. Well, I shouldn't say that, shall I? Cream crackers. But Alan's definitely got a pace on him and he wants to crack on. We've had some obstacles that you just wouldn't believe today. Cracks, we've had bits almost like cliffs to climb through. But when you've got a leader that says, let's go, let's go, let's go, and keeps the pace up, he caught me looking at my watch. He said, why are you looking at your watch? Time's irrelevant right now. And he's absolutely right. When you've got a goal, time is irrelevant. Keep marching on. So we'll see what happens in a while. Oh, we are absolutely goosed. Nothing left in the tank, but we've got 2.5 hours to go. The sun's still up. It's always up here, but so we're going to go for it. We're going to push for it. 2.5 hours to see if we can run off fumes for that long. 2.5 miles, sorry. See if we can run off fumes for that long.
Good man.
Feet.
vote on the clock when you get there. Arriving destination 15 feet, 12, 10, 2.
North Pole, top of the world, guys. Top of the world. We'll get that in a minute, Jake.
Oh, we're here, top of the world, and the feeling's just indescribable, absolutely indescribable.
There's nobody higher than you on the top of the planet. I mean, 7 billion people below you now, Jake.
Unbelievable feeling. Just very difficult to put into words how it feels, because it's been an incredible journey. Some amazing highs, some lows with freezing fingers. But every minute of it's been worth it. It's just absolutely unbelievable.
Well done, mate.
What's Jake doing? Well, he's running around the world. Literally, in just a few steps, he's travelled all the way around the world. Much easier than going around the equator.
Walk to the top of the planet, the last degree up to the North Pole. 6 days of pulling our sledges weighing over 60 kilo in temperatures of minus 35 degrees to support what I believe one of the most worthwhile charities in the UK. The NOS, the National Osteoporosis Society, do a great job for people with brittle bones.
And is he a great leader. He's also a really nice guy. He's bought us a bottle of port each for the pole and we're here. And also a bottle of ice wine. Although schoolboy error, he had backup everything. Spare tent, spare pole, spare skis, spare everything. What's the one thing that he didn't bring to the North Pole?
Corkscrew.
A corkscrew. You're in
Morning, Jakey.
Morning, everyone. spent the night at the pole, which was nice. Make a great story. But it is, even at the pole, it's not some magical place. It is still absolutely freezing. So it's probably about minus 35 outside, it's maybe colder.
35 in here, Jake. Yeah, another delay. Not only were the Russians 12 hours after our medical emergency to pick up Phil, 4 hours, then a 4 hour delay, then another 4 hour delay. We arrived here at the pole last night around about 9 o'clock. They told us they couldn't get us out last night, but then it would be around 3 o'clock today, and now we've been told 3 o'clock to become 5 o'clock. And we just hope that we don't get delayed again, because it is absolutely freezing. Even inside the tent, we're probably minus 25, minus 30 today. So. We really would like to go home right now.
That was it. Our expedition was over. We had walked for a week in temperatures between minus 30 and minus 35 degrees to the North Pole. An incredible adventure, stunning scenery, great leadership from Alan, and just a wonderful experience.